If the points 4, k, 2, 3 are conjugate points with respect to the circle x square plus y square minus 17 equal to 0, then find the value of k. So this is s equal to 0. So condition for conjugate points. Condition for conjugate points is s12 equal to 0. So for this circle, x1, x2 plus y1, y2 minus 17 equal to 0. So this is x1, y1 and x2, y2. X1, x2 is, so this is 8 plus y1, y2 is 3k. 3k is equal to 17. 3k is equal to 9. Therefore, k equal to 3. K value 3. Next term. Conjugate lines. Conjugate lines. Suppose L1 is equal to 0 is one straight line, L2 equal to 0 is one straight line, two lines. Two lines are said to be conjugate lines with respect to the circle S equal to 0. If the pole of either with respect to the circle S equal to 0 lies on the other line. Two lines are said to be conjugate lines with respect to the circle S equal to 0 if the pole of either, that is either first line or second line with respect to the circle S equal to 0 lies on the other line. Then we say that the two lines are called conjugate lines. Two lines are called conjugate lines. Next point. The condition. The condition that the lines L1x plus M1y plus N1 equal to 0 and L2x plus M2y plus N2 equal to 0 are conjugate lines with respect to the circle S equal to 0 is R square into L1 L2 plus M1 M2 is equal to L1G plus M1F minus N1 into L2G plus M2F minus N2. So this is the condition for conjugate lines. So, how to get this condition? See here, the pole, treat as this is first line, and this is first line, and this is second line. Now, the pole of first line, pole of one, formula minus g plus L1 r square by L1 g plus M1 f minus N1. And comma minus F plus M1 R square by L1G plus M1 F minus N1. So this is the pole of the first line. Pole of the line with respect to the circle S equal to 0. I think you know this formula. Pole of the line Lx plus My plus N equal to 0 is minus g plus L r square by L g plus M f minus N. comma minus F plus MR square by LG plus MF minus N, that is the formula. Here the line is L1X plus M1 by plus N1. According to that, you write here L1, this one, which lies on, which lies on second line, L2X plus M2Y plus EN2. In place of X and Y, you write this, you write these coordinates, you get the condition that the lines are conjugate lines. Got a problem? Show that the lines, show that the lines 2x plus 3y plus 11 equal to 0 and 2x minus 2y minus 1 equal to 0 are conjugate lines with respect to the circle, with respect to the circle x square plus y square plus 4x plus 6y plus 12 equal to 0, equal to 0. So condition for conjugate lines is here, what is g equal to 2, f is 3, c is 12. And L1, 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 2, M1, 3, and N1, N1 is 11. And second line, L2 is 2, M2 is minus 2, N2 is equal to minus 1. Now condition, condition for conjugate lines, R square into L1, L2 plus M1, M2. R square into L1, L2 plus M1, M2 is equal to L1G plus M1F minus N1 into L2G plus M2F minus N2, minus N2. Now find the value of this and value. If both are equal, then we say that the lines are conjugate lines. Conjugate lines. Where R is, where R equal to R square is G square plus F square minus C. R square is G square plus F square minus minus C. That is R square is R square G square 4 plus 9 minus 12, that equal to 1. So as 1, 1 into L1, L2, L1, L2 is 4, L1, L2 plus M1, M2 minus 6, minus 6. So this is, the value is equal to L1G, L1, L1 is 2 into G is, G is 2, 4 plus M1, M1 F, M1 F, F is, this is plus 9 minus N1, 11, 11 into L2 G, L2 G, so this is 4 plus M2 F, M2, M2 F, that is minus, minus 6, minus 6, this is minus, minus 1, so it is minus, minus 2. And this side it is so 13, 13 minus 11, 13 minus 11 into, so this is, it is So this becomes plus. So this is minus minus 1. So that is minus 2 is equal to, so this is 2 into minus 1. Minus 2 equal to minus 2. Therefore, the two lines are conjugate lines. Therefore, the two lines are conjugate lines. And one example, find the value of k. Find the value of k if the lines kx plus 3y minus 1 equal to 0 and 2x plus y plus 5 equal to 0 are conjugate lines with respect to the circle x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 1 sorry minus 4 equal 0. Find the value of k if the lines kx plus 3y minus 1 equal to 0, 2x plus y plus 5 equal to 0 are conjugate lines with respect to the circle x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 4 equal to 0. Then using the formula condition for conjugate lines. This is one method, or if it is you feel difficult to remember this formula, you have to find the pole of this line. Find the pole of the line with respect to the circle. How to find the pole of the line? By using the formula minus g plus lr square by lg plus mf minus n and minus f plus mr square by lg plus mf minus n. So we get the pole of the line with respect to the circle. At this point, substituting in this equation, you will get k value. So there are two methods. So which is you feel easy, you do this sum. Next one. Next point. So this is the circle S equal 0, this is the chord AB. Suppose midpoint of the chord is given. And how to find the equation of chord? So this is one formula. This is circle S equal 0. Now the equation of chord of the circle. S equal to 0 having x1 comma y1 is its midpoint is s1 is equal to s11. The equation of chord of the circle S equal to 0 having x1 comma y1 is its midpoint is S1 is equal to S11. Midpoint is given, how to find the equation of chord? By using this. What is center of circle? Minus z comma minus f. Suppose let the point is P, is the midpoint. Find the slope of this one. How to find the slope? This is y1 plus f by x1 plus g, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this is the slope of CP. And since CP is perpendicular to AB, therefore slope of AB equal to minus of x1 plus g by slope of this is. Slope of AB is minus of x1 plus g by y1 plus f. This is slope of CP, slope of CP, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this is slope of CP. Since CP is perpendicular to AB, therefore slope of AB is minus of x1 plus g by y1 plus f. And the point is x1 by y1, slope is this. So point slope form. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, then you get this s1 is equal to s11. So the equation of chord of the circle having x1 comma y1 is its midpoint is s1 is equal to s11. And the second point, suppose equation of chord is given. Chord is given. So find the midpoint of the chord. This is the point. Find the midpoint of the chord. How to find midpoint? Midpoint of chord is nothing but foot of perpendicular from center to the given line. Midpoint of the chord. Midpoint of chord is equal to foot of perpendicular from center to the given chord, to the given chord. Midpoint of the chord is foot of perpendicular from center to the given chord. Third point, the length of the chord of the circle length of chord of circle S equal to 0 having x1 comma y1 is its midpoint. Midpoint is 2 into root of mod S11. Length of the chord, 2 into root of mod S11. See, this is circle, S equal 0. So, this is the chord. The point is P, X1 comma Y1. So, this is A, this is B. Circle, S equal to 0. Circle S equal to 0. We know that a secant passing through the point P x1 comma y1 cuts this circle in two points A and B. Then the power of the point P is given by PA into PB. PA into PB is equal to what? Mod of S11. You know that a secant line passing through the point P cuts the circle in two distinct points A and B. Then the power of the point P is given by PA into PB, and PA into PB equal to mod of S11. Here the point lies inside the point. The point lies inside. Therefore, S11 is less than 0. Therefore, this is minus S11. The point less than 0, or of course length, it is enough. Length you can put mod. Since P is midpoint, P is midpoint. Therefore, PA is equal to PB. Therefore, PA into PA is equal to mod of S11. PA square is equal to mod S11. PA is equal to root of mod S11. Therefore, length of the chord. Therefore, length of chord. Chord AB is equal to 2 times of AP, that equal to 2 into root of mod S11. So the length of the chord is the length of the chord of the circle having x1 comma y1 is its midpoint is 2 into root of mod S11. Example. Find the midpoint of the chord. Find the midpoint of the chord intercepted by the circle. Find the midpoint of chord intercepted by the circle x square plus y square minus 2x minus 10y plus 1 equal to 0 on the line x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0 x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0. Here center of circle minus g comma minus f, that is 1 comma 5. The line is x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0. So let h comma k be the midpoint. So midpoint is foot of perpendicular. From center. This is treated as x1 comma y1. So h minus x1 by a equal to k minus y1 by b equal to minus of ax1 plus by1 plus c by a square plus b square. Foot of perpendicular from center 1 comma 5 to the line so h minus 1 by 1 is equal to k minus 5 by where b is minus 2 is equal to minus of a x1 plus b y1 minus 10 plus 7 by a square plus b square. H minus 1 is equal to k minus 5 by minus 2 is equal to, so this is 8 minus 10 minus 2, so this is plus 2, 2 by 5. So from this h minus 1 is equal to 2 by 5, therefore h equal to 1 plus 2 by 5, that is 7 by 5. And k minus 5 is equal to minus 4 by 5. Therefore, k equal to 5 minus 4 by 5. So, this is 21 by 5. Therefore, h comma k is equal to 7 by 7 by 5 comma 21 by 5. So this is the midpoint of the chord. Next one example. Find the length and midpoint. Find the length and midpoint of the chord 2x plus y minus 5 equal to 0. 2x plus y minus 5 equal to 0 with respect to the circle x square plus y square is equal to 9. X square plus y square is equal to 9. Find the length and midpoint of chord. See, this is the chord. So center of circle is 0 comma 0. So here midpoint is foot of perpendicular from 0 comma 0 to the line 2x plus y minus 5 equal to 0. Midpoint. After finding midpoint, length of chord is 2 into root of mod s11, 2 into root of mod s11, or this is one method, because x and y1, you know the midpoint of chord, so length of the chord is, midpoint is given 2 into root of mod s11, or by using the formula 2 root r square minus d square. So this is also one method. 2 root r square minus d square, where r is radius, d is length of the perpendicular from center to the given line. So you just try this problem. And problem, find the equation of chord of the circle x square plus y square minus 4x plus 6y minus 3 equal to 0, having 1 comma minus 2, 1 comma minus 2 is its midpoint, 1 comma minus 2 is its midpoint. So this is circle s equal to 0, this is the midpoint x1 comma y1. So midpoint is given, equation of chord is s1 is equal to s11. S1 is xx1 plus yy1 plus g of x plus x1 plus f of y plus y1 plus c is equal to x, s11 means here equation, that is x1 square plus y1 square minus 4x1 plus 6y1 minus 3. So xx1 is x minus 2y. g is minus 2, x plus 1. F is plus 3, y minus 2 minus 3 equal to x1 square. X1 square is 1, y1 square is 4. And here it is minus 4. Next to minus 12, minus 3. So 3 gets cancelled. So this is x minus 2y minus 2x minus 2 plus 3y minus minus 6. There also 4 gets cancelled, is equal to it is minus 11. Minus 11. So this is minus x. Next from these two plus y. Plus y minus 8 plus 11 equal to 0. So this is minus x plus y plus 3 equal to 0. That is x minus y minus 3 equal to 0. That is equation of chord. Next one, show that the area of triangle, show that the area of triangle formed by two tangents. Formed by two tangents through the point x1 comma y1 to the circle s equal to 0 and their chord of contact of the point P x1 comma y1 with respect to the circle S equal to 0 is R into S11 whole power 3 by 2 by S11 plus R square. Area of triangle formed by two tangents and their chord of contact. So this point is P. x1 comma y1. So this is one tangent. And also this is one tangent. Call it this is A, this is B. And this is the chord of contact. Chord of contact means what? Two tangents are drawn from an external point. The straight line joining the points of contact is called chord of contact. So we have to find the area of the triangle formed by pair of tangents and their chord of contact. So this is what PA, length of tangent, root S11. This is also root S11. Suppose this makes an angle, this is an angle, angle theta. Total angle is theta. So this is theta by 2. theta by 2. So from this tan theta by 2 is equal to r by root s11. Tan theta by 2 equal to r by root s11. So angle is from the triangle PAB. PAB. So area of triangle equal to half into PA into PB into sine theta. By using properties of triangles, area of triangle half AB sine C, half BC sine A, half CA sine B. By using that, half into C here. So this is PA and PB, and this angle is theta. Angle is theta. That equal half into PA root S11, PB root S11 into sin theta in terms of tan, 2 tan theta by 2 by 1 plus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta by 2. 1 plus tan square theta by 2. That is half into S11 into, so this is, think the 2 gets cancelled. Cancel, therefore this is S11 into tan theta by 2 r by root S11 by 1 plus r square by S11, r square by S11. So this is r into root S11, r into root S11 by, so this is S11 plus r square by S11, that is into S11. That is equal to r into, so here S11 whole power 1 by 2 into S11, that is S11 whole power 3 by 2 by S11 plus r square, S11 plus r square. So this is the area of triangle formed by two tangents and their chord of contact. And their chord of contact is r into S11 whole power 3 by 2 by S11 plus r square. Okay. Next, some important points. The locus of point of the locus of point of intersection, point of intersection of tangents, tangents drawn to the circle S equal to 0 which include an angle theta is S is equal to r square cot square theta by 2. S equal to r square cot square theta by 2. The locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn to the circle S equal to 0 which include an angle theta, that which makes an angle theta is S equal to r square cot square theta by 2. So these are all important points. See here. This angle is theta. The point is Px1, y1. S equal to 0. S equal to 0. From this, what about tan theta by 2? We know that. Tan theta by 2 equal to r by root S11. R by root S11. Therefore, root S11 is equal to, take that side, r into cot theta by 2. Squaring on both sides. S11 equal to r square into cot square theta by 2. Therefore, the locus locus of the point x1 comma y1 is in place of x and y1, you write simply x comma y, which is nothing but circle. So s is equal to r square cot square theta by 2. R square cot square theta by 2. Suppose this angle is 60 degrees, therefore s equal to r square cot square 30 degrees. Simply you get the locus. Second point, next point, the locus of chord of contact of tangents, tangents of the points with respect to the circle S equal to 0, which subtends, an angle theta, at its center, is S equal to r square tan square theta by 2. S equal to r square tan square theta by 2. The locus of chord of contact, of tangents, of the points with respect to the circle S equal to 0, which subtends an angle theta, at its center is S equal to r square tan square theta by 2. So circle. So this is the point P, x1 comma y1, So this is the chord of contact. This chord of contact subtends an angle theta at its center, here. So this is tangent and this is radius, which is nothing but normal. Angle is 90 degrees. So this is tangent, this is normal. There also angle is 90 degrees. Therefore, this is a quadrilateral, the sum of the angles is 360 degrees. So this is 90 and this is 90 and this is theta. And this is, this angle is pi minus theta, 180 degrees minus theta. So total, 360 degrees. So this makes an angle 180 minus 180 minus theta. Now, what is the formula? Tan theta by 2 is equal to r by root s11. What if this makes an angle? This is 180 minus, total 180 minus theta. This makes an angle. So this is 180 minus theta by 2. That is 90 minus theta by 2. Therefore, this is the tan of, where theta is, are you right? 180 minus theta by 2 is equal to r by root s11. So this is the tan of, 90 minus theta by 2 is equal to r by root s11, tan 90 minus theta by 2, that is cot theta by 2 is equal to r by root s11. Therefore root s11 is equal to r tan theta by 2. Squaring, therefore it is s11 is equal to r square tan square theta by 2. Therefore the locus is, s is equal to r square tan square theta by 2. Locus is r square tan square theta by 2. Next point. The locus of next point. The locus of midpoints of chords of the circle. Midpoints of chords of circle. X square plus y square equal to r square having a constant length of (2l) is x square plus y square equal to r square minus l square. The locus of midpoints of chords of the circle x square plus y square equal to r square having a constant length 2l is x square plus y square equal to r square minus l square. So this point is x1 by 1 point is x1 comma by 1. So this chord is AB. Length of the chord is equal to AB equal to 2 into root of mod S11. That is AB is length of the chord 2L is equal to 2 into root of the point lies inside the circle. I think you know about mod X. Mod x is equal to plus x if x is greater than 0, minus x if x is less than 0, 0 at x equal to 0. Just like here S11 is negative, that means what? Minus S11. So just like mod x is equal to minus x if x is negative, So 2 gets cancelled, therefore L is equal to here root of S11, squaring on both sides, L square is equal to minus S11. Therefore, that is S11 plus L square equal to 0. Where S11 for the circle? S11 is X1 square plus Y1 square minus R square plus L square equal to 0. Therefore, locus is x square plus y square is equal to r square minus l square. Let x1, y1 be the midpoint. Length of the chord is 2 into root of mod S11. Mod S11 is here, that is because the point x1, y1 lies inside. Therefore, that is minus S11. L is equal to this. So the locus of the point is x square plus y square equal to r square minus l square.